Welcome to Mastering Solutions. In this circular motion problem, we have a particle that's rotating in a circle with centripetal acceleration of 8 meters per second squared, and they want us to figure out how the acceleration will change if we A, double the radius without changing the speed, and then this double the speed without changing the radius. So what we're talking about is, of course, the formula for acceleration for circular motion is V squared over R. So looking at the relationship between acceleration and the radius is they're inverse proportional, meaning that if acceleration goes up, the radius is going to go down. And it's a one-to-one relationship. Now the relationship with the acceleration to the velocity is proportional, but with the velocity squared, if acceleration goes up, the velocity is going to quadruple. So how we want to do this is we want to represent it mathematically. You could think through it in your head conceptually and get the right answer, but I like to show it. So how we want to approach this problem is using ratios. It's a really great way to represent it to see what's happening. So we want to know with the new acceleration, how is it changing with respect to the old acceleration? So the old acceleration formula, of course, is V squared over R. But the new one, the speed or the velocity is not changing, but the radius is doubling. So now we have two fractions that we're dividing, which is the same as multiplying by the reciprocal. So we'll have V squared over 2R is equal to V squared over R. So the V squared will cancel. And now this will cancel the R and R. So what we're left with is 1/2. So what this means is that the new acceleration compared to the old acceleration, will be 1/2. So we have 8 meters per second squared. So that will go to 4 meters per second squared if we double the radius. For part B, we'll do the exact same thing. Only now what we're doing is we're doubling the velocity without changing the radius. So for the new acceleration to the old acceleration, we have same thing, V squared over R. But for the new acceleration, what we're doing is, we said, is doubling this. So 2 times the velocity, and this will be squared, divided by the radius isn't changing. So now when we do the same thing, we have 2 times the velocity squared divided by the radius multiplied by the radius over V squared. So those will cancel. And for here, what we need to do is we need to carry over the square. So what we'll have then is 4 times the velocity squared. So now the V squared will simplify. And what we're left is 4 over 1 or 4. So if we double the speed but don't change the radius, we are 4xing the acceleration. So 8 times 4 goes to 32 meters per second squared for the new acceleration if we double the speed.